The mantle appears to be missing. I am not referring to the most voluminous layer of Earth, Mars, or any rocky planet, but rather am referencing that of large differentiated asteroids. These asteroids, which are at least 40 kilometers or 24.9 miles wide, although most of what we are talking about today are larger than 140 kilometers or 87 miles wide, have a sufficient size that during the earliest stages of the solar system, they became differentiated. During this process, heavier materials sank into the core and lighter materials rose into the mantle and crust. This primarily occurred through the sheer amount of heat released by the radioactive decay of an isotope no longer found in abundance due to its short half-life, aluminum-26. As you might expect, learning about each layer of an asteroid by physically sending a probe and drilling into it is rather difficult, so pieces left over from collisions that fell to Earth, in other words meteorites, are used to learn immense information about our early solar system. And yet, the distribution of meteorites that originated from differentiated asteroids presents a major problem. While achondrites from such an asteroid's thin crust have been found in abundance, along with iron meteorites from an asteroid's core, what is seemingly missing among samples is what should comprise the second most voluminous layer in a differentiated asteroid, their olivine-rich mantle. And it gets even weirder. There is only an incredibly narrow layer, at most a kilometer thick, where the core and lowermost mantle segments of a differentiated asteroid meet, and meteorites from this region create what are known as pellucites. Out of 1,003 documented and classified meteorite falls, only 4 have been from this teeny tiny region. Thus, in theory, there should at least be dozens of meteorite fragments from a differentiated asteroid mantle, since they generally make up at least 30% by mass of such asteroids. And yet, out of 1,003 falls, only 2 olivine-rich mantle meteorites that were not pellucites have been found. This is what I mean by stating that the asteroid mantles appear to be missing, with this still unsolved geologic problem that if it were to be solved would have immense scientific value in multiple fields, being known as the missing mantle problem. Now, for all intents and purposes, mantles almost certainly still exist in differentiated asteroids, just for some reason there's a relative lack of meteorite samples from them. Since this geologic mystery is still unsolved, I thought that I would briefly cover several hypotheses that I deem to be plausible. These are in no particular order. Possibility 1. Due to an uneven distribution of various elements in the early solar nebula, olivine mantles are rarer than we currently think they are, as we are incorrectly thinking that all differentiated asteroids will have olivine-rich mantles just like Earth's upper mantle. While not always associated with this particular hypothesis, one additional possibility is that mantles in differentiated asteroids are largely comprised of pyroxene minerals rather than the olivine solid solution. This could in theory make some sense, because in Earth's mantle, 4 different groups of minerals are dominant at various depths. It is possible that something other than olivine might form in abundance due to the lower heating and pressure asteroid mantles would experience when compared to that of a far larger rocky planet. Another additional bit is that maybe olivine mantles are so rare because they were largely destroyed in the early solar system as large planets developed. In other words, what remains may represent the true abundance of olivine material as it formed that far out in the early solar system in the now asteroid belt. Maybe some of these large round differentiated asteroid bodies were even flown far out into space away from the solar system. Another possibility. Since mantle materials are weaker and less resistant to heat than that of differentiated asteroid cores, what fragments do get ejected in major collisions may be preferentially burned up and incinerated upon atmospheric entry to Earth. Or, such meteorites do reach Earth at a similar rate as other differentiated meteorite types, but weather much faster. Either of these scenarios would create a strong sampling bias. Another idea. Perhaps our current models of asteroid differentiation are wrong, and that, per a direct quote from this cited scientific paper, some planetary formation theory suggests that high viscosity and rapid heat loss in small planetesimals inhibit the formation of significant volumes of mantle material, Elkins, Tanton, et al., 2014, so only low quantities of dunitic material might be present as asteroids. Whichever of these is the case, or perhaps even some hypothesis which has not been made yet, the solving of this unanswered scientific problem will help explain so much about our early solar system.